after we learned what we needed to do, it was running at about 95 temperature. And now we know what we have to do to get the coolant. The car is such a slippery shape that very slight differences between the cars near the front can affect the airflow quite dramatically near the back.
Wow.
So we just don't have a large space yet of experience with this car to know instinctively what to do. Unequivocally things happen. But I was just chatting to somebody out there, and when we came here for the shakedown, we were just in pandemonium. We came back with a knockout. We were better organised. And here at the finals, we're better organised still. We're getting on top of it. There's still work to do, but I think it's work that can be done. We just had two cars demonstrate twice the range of every other competitor in this competition. So that's a cool thing. I take absolutely no pleasure whatsoever in what happened to one of the teams out there just now. They actually completed their general distance, but had one penalty. Over temperature in the cockpit, and that killed them. They couldn't make it. That's how close they were running. So I feel mightily for them. But also, I'm very happy for us.
I was just about to say, you must have a lot of satisfaction right now.
Yeah, this is cool. Of course, we've still got to do it this afternoon with the other car. So this is. So it's not over yet, but it's a good note on which to end the week for the mainstream cars. These are, I would say, certainly the most efficient four-seat luggage cars that have ever been built, and it's really cool to be part of this.
Well, congratulations.